Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here for the Dental Medical Convergence webinar, Your Mouth is Key to Your Overall Health. My name is Ashley Billings. I'm with Axia Public Relations, and we are working to share this important health message that the nonprofit, the Dental Medical Convergence, wants to share with you. I'm here with the founder of the nonprofit and a retired dentist, Dr. Chuck Reinertsen. Dr. Chuck, it is so good to see you today.
Great seeing you this morning, Ashley.
Let's get started on this important educational tool and share this message with our viewers, Dr. Chuck. First off, let's tell them a little bit about your background.
Well, I am just a messenger. I am not the expert. The experts have been working on this material for decades, and they've got hundreds of articles that actually show how much your mouth does affect your overall health. So it's good to be a messenger, but I'm not the expert. So just share the information. I graduated dental school in 1979 from University of Florida. I got a great education there. But as great as that education was, dentistry has changed a lot over the last 40 years. We learned many, many new things, not just materials and techniques, but also how much the mouth affects the overall health of the body. So I started practicing back in 1979 in Tiberias, Florida, and we've been here for, 42, 43 years. It's very different now, but about 8 years ago, I looked at some DVDs from the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health, and they connected the dots between the health of the mouth and how it affects the rest of the body. And it made perfectly good sense. We weren't taught this in dental school, but we learned it afterwards. I did a TED talk back in 2020, helping people understand how much the health of the mouth affects the overall body. And since retiring dentistry, I decided to start this foundation so that we can get the message to regular people. I tried going to a local hospital, and their decision was they didn't want dentists in there because they didn't want the dentists to diagnose problems that they could not treat. So I said, okay. So I went to physicians, and the physicians said that we love to ask questions about the mouth, but we don't have enough time. We only have so much time for patients. So I thought, well, if the hospitals aren't going to do it and the physicians aren't going to do it, the general public, families, they need to have this information. And that's the reason we started the foundation, to get this information to families. Yes, we want physicians to know what's going on, but it's not the physician who suffers when there's a problem caused from a dental issue in a patient. It's the patient that suffers and the family. So that's why we started the whole thing, is to go directly to families to help them understand how much the health of their mouth affects the health of the rest of their body.
And that's what we're going to be talking about today and sharing all this educational material with them. So we're happy to have you all here. Let's get started on our webinar. The first key point we want to make is your mouth is the front door to your body. I love when you say this, Dr. Chuck, because it means so much. Tell us about this.
Well, this is where everything comes into our body, if we think about it. You know, food, beverage, a lot of medications, they all come in through the front door of the body. And if you have a healthy front door, you're not going to have any bacteria that you have coming into your mouth getting into your bloodstream. If you don't have a healthy front door, you've got an open door for the bacteria to get right into invade the rest of your body. So we really need to keep that front door good and healthy. Physicians are quick when you get to be a certain age to recommend you get your back door checked with a colonoscopy. And that's a good thing to do. But rarely do they ask about the front door. And again, this is where everything is coming into the body. That's where we have things really clean and healthy so we can keep the body healthier.
That's right. Oral infections can quickly spread to other parts of the body. Tell us a little bit more about why a healthy mouth is so important.
Well, they've already identified the bacteria in gum disease for being causative for cardiovascular disease. That's a huge, huge issue right there. And what that means is you take away every other factor, take away weight, take away diet, take away exercise. It's the bacteria in the gums that get into the bloodstream that cause cardiovascular disease. Or that's one of the causes. There are other causes, but some of the experts believe that 50% of heart attacks come from dental infections. Well, the dental infections come from bacteria that we're not cleaning off of our teeth. So let's get to the source, not just treat the symptom. So cardiovascular disease, pregnancy complications, Alzheimer's disease, diabetic complications, there's all kinds of things. And it's common sense if you just think about it. If you have bacteria in your bloodstream, it doesn't matter if it comes from your mouth from your arm, from your leg? I mean, if you have an infection on your arm, can that bacteria get in your bloodstream? Sure it can, you know, and people will see that. So we just need to be aware that what happens in the mouth doesn't stay in our mouth. You know, what happens in Vegas may stay in Vegas, but what happens in our mouth goes through the whole body.
And tell us, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt, but tell us about the five things we need to be healthy.
Well, there are five things, let's go on to the next. There you go. Number one is what we eat. When I say eat, I don't mean just food. It means food, beverage, medications, and also injections. Whatever we're putting into our body, those are the things that are going to affect our body. Just like whatever you put into your automobile, your gas can. If you put in good fuel, you're going to run good. If you don't put in good fuel, you're probably going to have to go to the mechanic several times. Exercise is really important. That doesn't mean you have to join the gym. You have to move. You have to take a long walk. You have to get your body moving. If you sit sedentary, there's going to be some issues. In fact, they did a study back in the 80s of men that retired, sat down and did nothing. Do you know what their lifespan was if you just sat down, watched TV, ate, and that was it? Ashley, any idea?
Not many years, not past 50, I would say.
22 months. Gosh. 22 months. If people retired, sat down and did, this study was done on men, but they sat down and did nothing, 22 months was how long they lived on the average. So our body needs to move. We need some movement on that. A healthy mouth, and that's the thing I'm focused on right there, is a healthy mouth. You don't need a Hollywood smile to have a healthy mouth, but you need a healthy mouth to have a healthy heart. You need a healthy mouth to have a healthy body. So those are things that we need to understand, is that you don't have to have a beautiful Hollywood smile. You just have to have no infections. I would rather see somebody with no teeth than somebody with teeth that are infected. Hmm. So a good night's sleep. Our body does the best healing when we're in our deepest sleep. And getting a good night's sleep is becoming more and more difficult these days, it seems like, with everything going on. But a good night's sleep is when our body does the best healing. And our attitude is the last one. And the attitude actually controls the other four. With a good attitude, we're going to be careful with what we eat, get some exercise, keep our mouth clean, and maybe a good night's sleep. But if you've got a bad attitude, you're not going to do those things. You're not going to have personal encouragement to do it. So our attitude plays a huge, huge role in our overall health.
All right. Those are the five things we need to be healthy. Let's talk more about how people can focus on the mouth and keep their mouth healthy and have the best oral care possible.
Well, the first thing we can do is the free stuff at home. And that's what I talk to people and say, dental care is expensive. Well, dental neglect is very expensive, but dental care doesn't have to be that expensive. It all depends on what you do at home. And this is where, if you'll spend that time, 7 to 10 minutes, one time a day, thoroughly cleaning your teeth, instead of doing a lick and a promise two or three times a day. You know, I don't tell people, go brush your teeth. I say, no, go clean your teeth. Cleaning your teeth is very different than brushing your teeth. Cleaning your teeth includes in between your teeth. It includes way up by the gum line, all the way around, the back teeth too, not just the front teeth that show. So you got to spend that time taking that time. One of the things I really recommend, and they used to use it a lot, but I don't see them that much anymore, is disclosing tablets or disclosing pills that you can chew up. It's just a dye where you clean your teeth as good as you can, chew up this little pill that stains the bacteria that you left on your teeth that you thought you got off, rinse your mouth out, take a look at it, then go back and clean the stain off your teeth. So it does take a little bit of time. But when you think of how much time we spend on the phone, how much time we spend watching TV, how much time we spend doing other things, 7 to 10 minutes one time a day is really not that much to ask for the return on your investment, because the return on your time investment is huge. What I tell patients is the more time you spend at home taking care of your teeth, the less time you spend in my dental chair. The less time you spend at home taking care of your teeth, the more time you spend in the dental chair and the more money it costs you. So you can either do the free stuff at home, or you can neglect it and end up costing a whole lot more.
Prevention is key, you know?
Oh, it is. Prevention. I'd rather change the oil in my car than wait till it breaks and get a new engine, you know? And this is why I visit the dentist regularly. That is so important, because 90% of dental infections have no pain. People don't even know they have an infection going on. Many times we'll get new patients in, we do radiographs, x-rays on their teeth, we show abscesses going on. They had no idea there was no pain, yet that abscess was dumping bacteria into the bloodstream 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and they had no idea. So, and this is where it's good for you to communicate with your dentist and doctor on your oral health. You need to keep a good line of communication open. Hopefully your dentist is there not just to fix your problems, but to help you prevent problems in the future. So it's not just come in and we'll fix this until you get the next one. Hopefully it's come on, we'll fix this one, and let's start doing the homework that you can do daily so we don't have to do more and you can stay healthier. Anything other than a virgin tooth, a perfect tooth, is a compromise. So when you start putting fillings in teeth, when you start doing root canals and crowns, those are all compromises. The best thing is the natural tooth, and that's what we want to help people keep.
That's such important information, and communicating with your dentist and doctor can really make a difference in order to make sure that you are your healthiest self. So thank you so much for all that information, Dr. Chuck.
And going back to what you were saying, there is a lack of communication between dentists and physicians. And I hate to say it, but there's also a lack of communication between physicians and physicians. It's really hard to get everyone to talk together. We've compartmentalized the body to where you have the heart, you have the lungs, you have the kidneys, you have this, you know, the GI system, you've got the brain, you've got the eyes, you've got the mouth, you've got, you know, but there's a bloodstream that connects everything. So even though we have specialists in each one of these areas, if you have a problem in your mouth, it doesn't stay in your mouth. If you have an infection in your leg, it doesn't stay in your leg. So the whole body is connected. And I'm afraid that the communication between physicians and dentists and physicians and physicians, it could be better if the goal is to do what's best for the patient.
Exactly. And that's what we're really focusing on, is to bridge that divide that we see between the dental and medical community. And we hope that this information will encourage patients to go and speak to them and open up those communication lines. And that will be better for all of us, for all patient care, right?
That's just it. We want to work with physicians. We want there to be a communication. If the goal is to do what's best for the patient, there has to be communication between the doctors that are working on the same body. So this is one reason we have, again, the Dental Medical Convergence. Let's converge. Let's all work together. It's the same body. So thank you, Ashley. That's exactly right.
Yeah. Let's tell a little bit more about this nonprofit to our viewers right now. So like we said, Dr. Chuck founded this nonprofit to work to bridge the dental medical divide. And what we're doing with the nonprofit is educating you, educating families, doctors, dentists about oral health's connection to overall health, what we talked about today. And we are serving families, medical professionals, dentists, and consumers. We have lots of great educational material on our website that you can go and explore. You can print some of our PDFs that we have there. One of the great resources we have for patients has a PDF called 3 Ways to Improve Your Oral Hygiene Routine. And this is just more material that you can read through and you can share it with your family, your friends, your loved ones. There's also information for medical professionals there and lots of great articles and research articles and medical journal articles and stuff. So we really hope that you will take the time to discuss your dental health with your primary care physician, because if you do that today, you will have a healthier tomorrow. Right, Dr. Chuck?
Absolutely. And one of the things you can do is, number one, get your own education first. And if you go to the website, there's a lot of videos and research papers. If you want to look at the research papers, there's a lot of information that shows just how much the mouth affects the rest of the body. Once you understand it, the next time you see your physician, no matter who your physician is, just ask them, does the health of my mouth have anything to do with the health of the rest of my body? And then be quiet and listen to their answer. If their answer is, yeah, there's a big link, good for you, you got a good doctor. If their answer is, well, I don't know, please refer them to the website, thedentalmedicalconvergence.org. And there's a page in there just for physicians that has links to the research to where they can understand just how much the health of the mouth does affect. I'm not making this stuff up, it's for real. So if the physician is not that aware, now you have a place to send them. if the physician says, no, the health of your mouth has nothing to do with the health of the rest of your body. You can evaluate if you want to stay in that physician's care or not, because we have to include that if the goal is to do what's best for the patient, if the goal is to have the patient be healthy. So there are some things that you can do, and talking with your physician is high on the list.
Mm-hmm. All right. So much great information, and there are so many great resources out there for patients and medical professionals, like we said, at the dentalmedicalconvergence.org. We are so happy that you all joined us today for this webinar. We hope that you learned some new information. And Dr. Chuck, we appreciate all that you're doing with this nonprofit to spread this important message about how your mouth is key to your overall health.
Thank you so much. That's what we want to do, is please share this information with your families, with your friends. You know, we're not selling anything. We're giving information, but hopefully one of the things we're giving you is you won't have to go through the trauma of some of the medical events that are caused from heart attacks, strokes, these other things. We don't want you to go through that. You or the family to go through it. So let's stay healthy. Let's just stay healthy.
Thank you so much, Dr. Chuck, and thank you for being here today.
My pleasure. Thank you so much, Ashley.
Have a great day.
Thank you.